Hi, this is Erin from MCP Actions. Today I'm going to show you how to install and use our Mini Enlighten free presets for Lightroom 4. Mini Enlighten contains a small sample of the about 200 presets that are contained in full Enlighten, which is our comprehensive set of presets for Lightroom 4. This set is designed to speed up your workflow with presets that stack innovatively. No need to worry that one preset will override the other when you're using Enlighten. I'm going to start by opening my downloads folder. You can see that I've already downloaded the product from MCP's website onto my computer. It's a compressed or zipped file. To unzip it, I will double click on it. And you can see that there's now an unzipped folder here in my downloads. Inside this unzipped folder, you'll find directions for installing and using MCP Mini Enlighten. I do suggest reading through those if you're not familiar with presets or if you have any questions after watching this video. Next, I'm going to take this folder, the one inside the unzipped folder. It's called MCP Mini Enlighten Lightroom 4 Presets. Inside it are all of the presets that we're about to install. I am going to right-click on this folder and select Copy. Now I'm going to go into Lightroom, and if I were on a PC, I would go to the Edit menu. On Macs, I'm going to go to the Lightroom menu, and I'm going to open Preferences. So whether you're on a PC or a Mac, you're looking for the Preferences folder. And again, on PCs, it's under the Edit menu. And on Macs, it's under the Lightroom menu. So with Store Presets with Catalog turned off, I'm going to click on Show Lightroom Presets folder. You can see that Finder is open now. If I were on a PC, this would be the Explorer. The Lightroom folder is what is open. And within that, I'm going to click on Develop Presets. Within Develop Presets, I'm going to right-click and paste the folder that I just copied from my download. So you can see now MCP Mini Enlighten Lightroom 4 Presets is in the appropriate folder. Now, if you've never installed presets before, you're probably only going to have this User Presets folder here. So don't worry if your Finder or Explorer doesn't look as full as mine does. The next step is to close the Explorer or the Finder, close this Preferences window, and then restart Lightroom. And now you can see that Lightroom has reopened, and over here on the left in my Presets panel, I've now got MCP Mini Enlighten Lightroom 4 Presets. I click on this arrow to open the Presets folder and to see what I've just installed. To show you how to use these presets, I'm going to go to this beautiful image from Kelly Roper Photography, and I'm going to apply a couple different looks to the photo. Now, just to give you kind of a broad overview of what the Mini Enlighten presets do, you can see that we've given you two exposure adjustments, one to lighten by a third a stop and one to darken by a third a stop. We've given you two base styles, awake and grunge black and white, and then we've given you three mini enhancers. So these are like overlays that tone your image. And then finally, we've given you the complete the look section where you can either brighten or darken midtones just a little bit, or you can add a touch of contrast. Each different type of preset comes with its own reset. So if you didn't like the lighting adjustment that you applied, you could reset only the lighting without resetting all of your prior edits. Now remember that these presets that we're looking at in Mini Enlighten are just a few samples from our bigger full Enlighten set, which you can see up here. It actually contains four folders. I am going to start by doing a color edit on this photo. Awake is the color preset we've given you, and you can see by applying it that it increases contrast, increases vibrance, and improves the lighting of the photo. I think I can probably increase exposure just a little bit, and so I'm going to go back and apply lighten one third a stop, and I like that look. And now to give it a tone, I am going to apply Urban Bliss, which adds just a little bit of rose to the image. Now I'm going to show you what you can do using Full Enlighten. I'm going to return to our Full Enlighten Step 3, which is the Enhance Your Photo section. And I am going down to the color tweaks, and I'm going to hit Deepen Blues. And you can see by doing that that you bring out very quickly all the blues of the sand and the water. Now I'm going to reset the entire edit by clicking Reset in the bottom right corner of the Develop module. And now I'm going to do a black and white edit. I'm going to start with Grunge Black and White. And this one makes the image pretty dark, so I am going to go up to our Full Enlighten Step 1, which contains white balance tweaks as well as lighting tweaks. Now, the benefit of having these presets is that you can use your navigator panel and you can hover over them to see what the lighting adjustment is going to do to your photo. So this is a quick way to get a good estimate of whether you're about to click on the right preset or whether you need to go about any further. So I think that looking in the navigator up here, lightening one stop is too bright, so I'm going to go down to lighten two-thirds a stop. That looks great for this image. So again, now that I've applied the black and white look and tweaked the exposure on this photo, I'm going to go to our Full Enlighten Step 4, complete the look, and I am going to apply slight highlight protection just to make sure that I'm not blowing out anything up here in the water or on the sequins. Now for my final step of this edit, I'm going to do some selective sharpening using the local adjustment brush presets that come with Full Enlighten. Again, these are not part of Mini Enlighten, but you can purchase Full Enlighten to use the adjustment brush. I'm going to go over here to the right side of my Develop panel and turn on my adjustment brush tool. And then from the Effect drop-down menu, I am going to choose Sharpen. And now I'm going to reduce the size of this brush by just a little bit using the size slider. And I am going to paint over this girl's eyes to increase the sharpness in the eyes. I can type the letter O to show me a red overlay over where I've painted. And now I'm going to make the brush a bit larger. And I am going to sharpen the sequins of the dress as well. And I'll make it just a bit smaller. And so I am happy with my painting here, and I'm going to end by making the brush just a little bit smaller and sharpening her headband. I'm going to type the letter O again to toggle off that red overlay. And I'm going to turn off my adjustment brush. So this is just a small sample of what you can do using our Mini Enlighten presets and our Full Enlighten presets for Lightroom 4. Please note that you do need Lightroom 4 to use these presets. They don't work in prior versions of Lightroom. If you like Mini, you'll definitely love the countless additional looks and tweaks that Full Enlighten will give you. The sooner you purchase it, the more quickly you'll be creating beautiful edits with an efficient workflow. Thanks so much for watching this video. If you have other questions, please visit our website, mcpactions.com.